knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Okay, let's practice using solubility product constants. Fluorite, or CaF2, is slightly water-soluble and dissolves according to the following equation. So we have fluorite solid in equilibrium with the calcium 2+ ion and 2 fluoride ions. Now, a saturated fluorite solution is measured as having a calcium ion concentration of 2.1 times 10 to the negative 4 molar. So, what is the solubility product for fluorite? So that's all the information we need. Go ahead and give this a try. So let's put our equilibrium up top, and once again, we know that the calcium ion concentration is 2.1 times 10 to the negative 4 molar. So what can we do with this information? Well, we know that fluorite is going to dissolve to give a calcium ion and 2 fluoride ions. So if enough fluorite has dissolved so as to give a calcium ion concentration of that magnitude, then we know that the fluoride ion concentration must be double that, because there are 2 fluorides that form for every calcium ion. So that means the fluoride ion concentration must be 4.2 times 10 to the negative 4 molar, right? That is exactly double the calcium ion concentration. So we figure that out just by stoichiometry. Now let's write our KSP expression. So this is just like any other equilibrium expression. It involves only aqueous or gaseous species. And so that means we're just going to have the calcium ion concentration times the fluoride ion concentration squared. And then we don't have to put that over any reactants because the reactant is a solid. Now we have all the information we need. We have the calcium ion concentration and we have the fluoride ion concentration. So we just plug those numbers in. And then we do the arithmetic, and we get a KSP value of 3.7 times 10 to the negative 11.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.